he probably felt bad, so he probably went to them and said, hey, look, is it okay if I do this? It's gonna have nothing to do with the comics, just letting people know what I wanted to do instead of going in this direction. And they might have been okay with it because it has nothing to do with the comic anymore. It's not like, oh, this is what we were, or it's not like us reading and going like, oh, we want to see that. Oh, this is what they should do. No. It's gonna have no impact on the comic. And if he did that and Archie was cool with it, then there's no problem. But I think what Ken, I'm not trying to defend him here, but I think what Ken is trying to point out to everybody is Ian Flynn, you know, he writes for the comic, so basically he's got to be careful about what he does. And by doing this, let me get some coffee here. Makes it easier to talk and think. Oh, it's better. You know, maybe he feels, in his opinion, that Ian Flynn has no, you know, that basically Ian Flynn hasn't any real idea of what goes on behind the scenes with a comic book publisher. That even though he is licensed, or he's a freelance writer in a sense, he's the head writer for one of the most popular comics Archie has, so why would you put that at risk? And I think maybe that's what Ken, in his opinion, is thinking. It's like, why would this guy who is potentially good and basically took over for me when I was let go, why is he risking his job not knowing what he's doing? I mean, why is he risking his job doing this? He doesn't understand that unless you're no longer working for them, and you're a freelance guy, and you're able to do your own stuff, you can't do this. You know, to him, I'm not trying to defend him, but it almost sounds like what Ken is saying is that, you know, Ian is not, you know, he's not like I mentioned earlier, and I'm sure other fans have pointed out in comparison, he's not like a Hollywood writer. He's not like some kind of screenwriter for a television show or for a movie. Well, mainly for a movie. He's not a freelance screenwriter that's contracted to one company to write for all the movies. He's not contracted to do that. You know, he's not that kind of writer that's not contracted, that basically they're hired on to write the script and that's it. You know, they're not contracted to the studio. And I guess in his opinion, Ian doesn't realize that he's not in that same category. But again, even though his intentions may be for those that defend Ken Penders and might agree with him, even though his intentions might be good in his thought process, some still look at it maybe as envy. That maybe because Ian has become more popular, fans have gotten behind him more often, and even have gotten behind his wife, Aaliyah, that he doesn't want to see him succeed. I mean, I'm sure Ken Penders is going to reply somehow when people make a comparison saying like, oh, well, he talked about what he had planned. But I think the difference is, and I'm sure Ken Penders might reply to that somehow, if not already, the difference is, and again, not defending the guy or anything, because I still don't think this makes any sense. I'm like, why are you worried about someone that probably already got the okay from the people he's working with or working for to do this? Why are you so worried about this? What concern of it is it of yours? Because honestly, it shouldn't be any concern, right? Well, here's the thing though. I think from Ken's point of view, if someone points out to him, well, you said this, you shared your plans and all that, here's what Ken's reply might be, and this is just my opinion. but I'm sure this might be his reply in some way, that when he revealed what he had planned originally before he was let go, he'll probably point out that he did that after he was let go, after he was no longer contracted, or he no longer was working for the book or working for the publisher. That's why he was able to finally say those things. And in comparison, he'll probably reply and say that the difference being, Ian is currently writing for the publisher, he's currently writing for the book, so he shouldn't be doing this right now. He should wait until maybe he's let go, and then he can go on and do it. He shouldn't, be doing this right now. He shouldn't be publishing this Lost Hedgehog Tales right now, where initially he could end up getting in a lot of shit, if you know what I'm saying. Now, again, not defending him, because like I said, to me it doesn't make any sense either. It doesn't make any real sense. But, why worry yourself with something that he probably got the okay to do anyway? Why, is it because he's gonna mention your characters? What, because he mentioned Hershey? Is that it? What, you don't want no indication, no mention of your characters whatsoever? Even if it's in a freelanced, unpublicated, nothing to do with Archie Comics or the Sonic comic whatsoever, you don't even want them mentioned in basically what is essentially the uncut edition, basically the blueprints publication, sort of like the blueprints, the original blueprints of what was supposed to be. He can't even mention your characters by name. What is he supposed to say? Oh, and that black cat or that black cat that was married to that skunk and everything, and that skunk got possessed or was revealed to be working for Nogus. And is he supposed to just call him Black Cat and Black Skunk? Again, that doesn't make any sense. Again, it doesn't make any sense whatsoever. So, I still don't get it myself. I really don't. I really don't get it myself because, I don't get it. I don't get it. I don't get it, honestly. Because it's like, okay, just because he mentioned the names, he can't do that. Now I can honestly probably see what Ken, from his point of view, from his opinion, his thought process, might be seeing this. Maybe there's an agreement that maybe Ian Flynn doesn't have any idea about. And if Ian Flynn had any indication maybe of this agreement, that maybe Ian Flynn wouldn't have done Lost Hedgehog Tales, so even if he did, he probably would have slowly hinted at said characters without mentioning them. So, maybe there was some kind of secret, because we don't know. Okay, here's the thing. That last lawsuit that got settled, we don't know the terms of the agreements, right? Who's to say the terms and agreement didn't indicate that who's to say the terms of agreement, who's to say this agreement, if you will, that Ken and Archie had, who's to say that part of that agreement was that no matter what, nobody currently working on the comic, whether writing or drawing for it, whatever, can't mention the characters by name or physically show them. So if that is part of the settlement, if that's part of that secret settlement that nobody knows the details about, not even Ian Flynn, then honestly to me, this shows stupidity on both Archie Comics and Ken Penders. Because you think Ken Penders would, if he has Ian Flynn's email, and I'm sure he does, and maybe even Ian Flynn's number, would email and call him up and say, hey man, look, just to let you know, whatever you do in the future, whether you're still working for the book or you're not, you think you'd give him an email, okay, you think Archie Comics or even Ken Penders themselves would let Ian Flynn know, hey, by the way, whatever you do in the future, while you're still working for this book, or while still working for us, still writing for this book, whatever you do, don't mention the characters in any shape or form. I mean, honestly, if they would have said that, originally, if that's part of the settlement, that nobody, even if it's a project, sort of like a fan project, a free thing for the fans to have an idea of what it was supposed to be, even with something like that, just because Ian Flynn's working for Archie, working on the Sonic comic and other things for Archie, and so do those subdivisions, that he can't mention characters like Jeffrey, Hershey, or Julie Sue. He can't do that. Honestly? Because, if that is part of the settlement, because, again, nobody knows the details. I don't think Ian Flynn even knows the details. If that's part of the settlement, then Archie Comics should have at least let Ian Flynn know. They should have said, look, we know you're planning to do this Lost Hedgehog Tales to kind of give the fan... I mean, because even if he went to Archie Comics and got the okay to do it, you think Archie Comics would have told him, hey, look, that's great and everything, and you got our permission to do it, but, oh, by the way, whatever you do, don't mention the characters of Jeffrey, Hershey, Julie Sue, or anything. Don't mention any of Ken's characters by name whatsoever. You can hint at them, maybe call them like Black Skunk, Black Cat, whatever, Purple Echidna, whatever. Don't mention their names. Or hint, basically kind of hint at them in some ways, but don't mention them. You know, if that's the case, and again, if that was part of the settlement, you know, they should have said something. They should have came out and they should have said something. That dog has to go out and party in the rain. But like I said, you think if that was part of the settlement, they would have said something. And I think maybe that's what it is. I think that's what, when Ken Penders, in my opinion, again, not defending the guy, because it doesn't make sense in any way, and I don't think he's going to win, depending on what happens, let's be honest, the guy basically has a losing freaking cause on his hands. But if that's the quagmire that he's talking about, the shit that he's saying, basically the shit that he's saying Ian Flynn is stepping into, then you know what? Why don't Archie Comics and Ken Penders get the okay from the Supreme Court and publicly show the world, the fans, what the agreement was, what's okay and what's not okay, and be done with it? Because this is stupid. Purely stupid. I mean, look, a lot of us fans, including me, have been waiting and waiting and waiting for some kind of indication of Lost Hedgehog Tales. Whether we like Ian Flynn or we don't. We've been wanting to know exactly what was going to happen originally. And some of us did call exactly what was going to happen originally. We pretty much called some of it, or had an idea basically of what was going to happen. And yet, Lost Hedgehog Tales, even though part one, chapter one, is out, still may be facing a brick wall due to the fact that maybe part of that settlement that nobody knows the details of, Part of it is the fact that the characters can't even be mentioned by name. Even if it's in something that's meant to give the fans an idea of what was originally going to happen. So he can't even mention the characters by name. Is that what's going on? Again, if that's the case, you think Archie Comics or even Ken Penders would have the sense to call him up, email him, and say, "Man, look, you know, whatever you do in the future, you're still working on the book, still working for Archie, don't mention the characters in any shape or form." Or you think Archie, if they gave him the okay to do Lost Hedgehog Tales, would have told him, "Hey, look, that's fine and everything, man, but whatever you do, don't mention any of Ken Penders' characters by names or even descriptions. You can hint at what was going to be, but don't ever talk about them. Don't ever mention them." You think they would have done that, but they didn't. And to me, that is complete BS. And I think people watching this would understand and agree. Because it is complete BS. Here's the thing. I have to check my phone's there. My phone message is there. But here's the thing. Again, this is stupidity on both ends if that's the case. This is stupidity on Ken and Archie's if that's the case. Because this is why, even if somebody tells you, don't say anything, even to your employees or your freelancer or the people that work for you or you've hired to do this, this is why you at least need to give them an idea. Talk to them. Take them in private and say, or ask, "Hey, can we tell the people that are working on certain things privately, but have them not tell anything?" If they would have at least talked to Ian in private and said, "Look, we have no problem with your Lost Hedgehog Tales, but whatever you do, don't do this." It would have made sense. You know, I've always felt the Lost Hedgehog Tales, the reason it took so long was due to legal matters. And you know what? If that's the case, then I don't know what else to say. Again, I'm not defending Ken because I think this whole thing's stupid. Really, I do. I think it's complete BS. I mean, why are you causing trouble over something that's initially not licensed to Archie Comics, not licensed to Sega, not even licensed to you? Why are you causing a storm over this? Why are you causing a shitstorm over this? Why? Because it's mentioning your characters? He's not saying, "Oh, this is Hershey St. John and Jeffrey St. John. I own the characters. I can mention them because I have a right to own them." No. He's mentioning them as a fan. You know how many fans out there? I'm trying to get my dog in. But you know how many fans out there do fan art, fan fiction at DeviantArt, fanfiction.net, other places? Talk using the characters of Penders along with the characters of Sonic? A lot! There's a lot of people doing that. There's a lot of people doing that, even as we speak. And this is complete BS. You know why it's complete BS? It's complete BS due to the fact,